So I now have this lovely little ready aim fire GUI. So whenever I run it, I always have to move it onto my screen and I hit fire and I go and I get a hit and this is amazing. Now I'm getting kind of annoyed about the fact that every time I run this, it's off my screen and I have to fix it. And part of that's my fault because I'm operating at a different resolution than my screen is set for, so it thinks that it's centering it, but it's really not. So something that I'm gonna do is I'm going to go to internet and I'm going to say change GUI position, MATLAB, and see what happens. Okay. All right. So I can look at this move GUI. There's something called move GUI. It specifically says to specify it as a create callback function or create function callback for the figure, and then I can just say move GUI position, and I can pick north, south, east, west, blah, 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 blah. Okay, so I'm gonna go do that somehow. I'm gonna go to MATLAB and I'm gonna open up my figure, and it told me to create it as a callback on the figure. So that means if I right click the figure and link the callbacks, there should be something called create function. There it is. So I'm gonna do create function. Okay, now theoretically, I can just type move GUI and I'm gonna say center it, because I want you to center it on the screen, and I'm gonna see what happens. I'm going to run it, and it's exactly where it was before. So that must mean it thinks that's where the thing is. So what were some of my other options? I had north, south, east, so I'm going to go north. So let's see what north is. Okay, so it does move. It doesn't work. I just apparently need to be northwest. Okay, so I can say northwest. Okay, now I'm happy. Now this is less stressful, strenuous, upsetting to have to constantly be messing around with this. Okay, so fire. Yay. Okay. So now I think it would be great if we did something where it's like, if you get close, it like says something nice. Okay, so I'm gonna make a little bit more room on here. So first of all, this is kind of lame. I haven't even put a title on this, so I'm gonna call it Super Awesome Fun Game. Okay. I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger, so I'm gonna change the font size. And that's fine. Super awesome fun game. All right, so maybe what I'll do is have like a little spot where like it says, like if I get close, I want it to say like, keep trying, or this can be like instructions in general. So I'm gonna do this, and it's gonna start by saying, enter a velocity and angle and hit fire. So there's some instructions or something like that. I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger and 12 or 10, I don't know. It doesn't matter, I'm just playing around. So I'm gonna call it Comic Sans, because it's hilarious there. Comic Sans will save the world. Not. All right. That's so bad. I can't even look at that. I forgot what it was before. What is the other one? Come here. It was MS Sans Serif. Okay. I'm going back to that because Comic Sans freaks me out. Okay. All right. There we go. Enter velocity and angle and hit fire. Okay. So I've now given them instructions. I wonder if I can make it bold. Font weight. Ooh, bold. That's very impressive. I'm going to make my title bold because I'm that kind of girl. Bold. Amazing. Okay. Now it doesn't say fun game, it just says super awesome fun, which is totally true. Okay. So enter velocity and hit fire. Okay, so that way I'm telling the user what to do. I'm going to call this static text box something specific. Right now it's just called generically text 4, so I'm going to call this text instructions. Okay, so I'm going to make that be the instructions. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, like, if it's less than 5, then clearly it's a hit. But maybe it's less than like 20, okay? And if it's 20, then for the moment, I'm just gonna do a message box that says close, just to make sure the code works. Otherwise, I'm gonna do a message box that says keep trying. And remember, I'm just using message boxes not because I'm incapable of anything else. I'm just using message boxes because it makes me feel like I can at least test the code and I'm not trying to interact with the GUI more than I strictly need to at the moment. And you might say, well, isn't 20, you know, isn't this going to run multiple times? Because if it's 4, it's going to be here and it's going to be here. The answer is no, because if it's 4, the way the if statement works, so if this value here is 4, it's going to run this and then it's going to exit the if statement. So even if it's 4, it's never, what I'm saying is once it meets something that it likes, it's never going to look at the rest of this. So it's like that doesn't even exist. So if the absolute value of the blah blah minus the blah blah is 4, it's like the rest of the code does not even exist. So if it's 15, then it's going to pop down here and it's going to get it. If it's 25, it's going to come all the way down here. So let's run this. And look, I don't have to move it. Now, I haven't changed anything, so it's going to be hit. Oh, and now notice that my title isn't here. So this is something that can happen when you get overexcited, as I tend to do when I'm doing GUIs, which is I haven't saved the figure. So one of the things that's kind of useful to do is go ahead and exit out of the figure before you run it and save it. That way, whenever I go, see, now it's showing up, but I need to fix that. So I'm going to say fire. It's going to say hit. Okay. So let's see if I can change the velocity just a little bit. Close. Okay, and let's see if I change it a little bit more. Keep trying. Okay, so it's working the way I want it to. Awesome. That's exactly what needs to happen. I am going to go fix the fact that my stuff is overlaid a little bit. That should fix it. Yes. Okay. Great. Okay, now I call that TXT instructions. So now instead of doing a message box, what I'd like to do is I would like to set the value of handles.textInstructions. I would like to change the value of its string to hit. Okay, so look at what this did, is I'm going to set the value of this text.instructions thing, handles.text.instructions. I'm going to change it, its string property, to hit. Okay, now before I go change them all for everything, I'm just going to make sure this works. I'm going to run this again. Bam, and that's how we do it in big time, because YouTube videos are big time. Okay, so we've got this, and I'm going to do the same thing. So I'm going to say close. And, whoa, not that. I'm not going to do that. And keep trying. Okay. So, ba-choo! Hit! Hit! Oh, wait, I have to change this. Close! Oh, I wish I could hit enter and make that happen. I wonder if there's a way to do that. Keep trying! Okay. And it's a little silly, weird, why it keeps leaving that, but I just don't care that much to fix it. Right now we're just doing this for fun. Okay. Now the problem is whenever I hit, it just keeps letting me hit it again and again, which is kind of sad, and poor little target just keeps getting walloped. So what I want to do is I want to set it up to where if I get a hit, then I want to ask, do you want to play again? Okay. So let's do that. So let's say call it play again. So if we get a hit, then we're going to say, not an input statement, let's do a menu. So it'll pop up. Do you want to play again? Yes. And no. Okay. All right. So play again is either going to be equal to, well, 0 if they exit out of it, 1 if they hit yes, or 2 if they hit no. So what I want to do is I'm now going to do, I can actually just do this straight up with an if statement. So if play again is going to be equal to 1, then we want to play again. Let's see. Is this exactly how I want to do it? No, because, okay, so actually I'm not going to put this outside. I'm going to put it inside here because I don't want it to like exit the game because it's not going to ask me if I want to play again. So I really don't want to even consider any of this logic unless I got a hit. So I'm going to do it in here. So if play again is equal to 1, then I just want to run the code again. So I'm going to close the current code and then I'm going to do ready, aim, fire again. Otherwise, I'm just going to close it. And maybe I'm going to do a message box that says, thank you for playing. I'm afraid that I'm like overextending my basic skills. And it's a message box. Okay. All right, so let's see what happens if I run this. And I haven't really tested this outside of the GUI, so it freaks me out a little bit, but we're gonna try it. Okay, so I'm gonna hit, and you wanna play again. Yes? Look at that. This is totally big time. This is totally hardcore big time. No. And it said thank you for playing, but it went away and it's still here. So that's lovely. No? Okay, so it didn't actually close. I wonder what I can do. How do I make a GUI close? I wonder if it works without the message box. Let's just try it. Maybe the message box is somehow freaking it out. Whoa, I can't type. Here we go. I'm just gonna do that because I don't know what that does. And I know it works here, so I don't know why it doesn't work here. So, fire, no, it closed. Okay, so the message box is freaking out. What if I put the message box second? No. Okay, no message box. Oh wait, there's my message box. It's hiding. This is amazing. Except it's totally not there. All right, let me try it one more time. No. All right, so the stupid message box isn't working, but I don't care about it that much, so I'm just gonna take it away. It's not that important, but isn't that interesting that it didn't work with the message box, but it does work without. So who knows? You never know why these things do or don't work, except for the fact that it's code and doing exactly what you tell it to do. Sometimes it just functions in a specific way. Okay, now to make this game actually useful and fun, I need to take off the fact that it's going to randomly the fact that it's giving me the same target every time. So what I want to do is I want to come in here and I want to take out that thing where I hard-coded in the target, and now I'm going to run it so now the target is not even close. So, all right, well, that was amazing. Okay, yes, I want to play again. That was so much fun. All right, oh, apparently I'm close already. I might need to. That doesn't seem like it's within, oh, because it's within 20, so 20 is close. Okay, I get it, I get that. Keep trying, okay. So I'm now able to get all of the, well, that was actually really impressive. I was able to get all of the values, so that's pretty cool. Like, well, I have to change the angle, I know, but you know, we could pretend that people are gonna have fun with it and do that. So this seems pretty functional. That's really, really exciting.